My name is Niv, you know me, you've been here before, or maybe you haven't.
Alright, so I haven't been here.
Maybe 3 years? Now, in the past 3 years in LA, I worked here, I worked there, but I also became an introduction leader for the Landmark Forum. I wanted to combine these two passions of mine, both shooting a video blog and leading introductions to the Landmark Forum. So I wanted to create a video blog about breakthroughs. So my intention, I want to make a real difference for you in how you see your life, how you see your circumstances, in the areas and the topics that you care the most about. Your money, relationships, self-expression, leadership, areas that you don't talk to people about them every day, but you think about them all the time. Here is the first one, enjoy.
What does it mean to be constrained with money?
Part here,
it's broken.
It can't hold on.
Yeah. What are we doing here? What happened?
The coupler on the trailer broke, and while we were driving down the highway, the trailer came off of the hitch. Time after time, I've been super constrained with money.
When it comes to spending money on things that occur to me as unnecessary, specifically, those Apple AirPods. I've always wanted those, but I just, no matter what, I couldn't allow myself to buy myself AirPods.
Yeah.
And not only that, but when I see someone walking down the street with AirPods, I think to myself, how could an idiot spend $150 on that? And then they walk by me and I think to myself, but God, I'd really love those AirPods. I'm so jealous of people that just buy stuff for themselves. Like, it occurs to me as crazy and unnecessary. It occurs to me as crazy. It doesn't mean that it's crazy. That's been my constraint. I put myself in a money seminar at Landmark. There was this one assignment that we got. The assignment was investigate my family's financial lineage. I call up my dad and I say, Dad, what's the farthest back that you know in our family?
So, what are we doing now?
Clearly, we're sitting like two weirdos in the dark.
Clearly.
Around the campfire. You're getting a history lesson. American history.
American history.
Why this is the greatest nation on God's green earth.
Tell me, the eggshell in the fire is good for the environment?
I don't know, maybe.
It's very toxic.
Yes, you're probably right.
It's very toxic.
Very toxic.
Your grandmother and your grandfather were very wealthy people in southern Poland before World War II. When the Nazis came into power, your grandfather, he went to Switzerland and he put all of his money in a Swiss bank. Germany invaded Poland, took all of the family's property. Much of my family was murdered in the Holocaust. My grandparents survived. They went to Israel after the war with nothing. My grandfather was one of the few people that had a stash of money hidden away in a Swiss bank. And he bought himself an apartment. They had a really great life. But if you looked at my grandfather in his day-to-day life, they would eat some cottage cheese, a pickle, a piece of toast, and a hard-boiled egg.
We do this, yes?
Yeah.
Scramble, yes. Yes. We cook. We don't see, let it bake.
The burned eggshell is the symbol of the Jewish people.
Yeah, yes. Yes. Salt is good. Food is ready, come to the table.
My grandfather would tell my dad, you always have to have money set aside for when you need it, you know, for like a catastrophe. The funny thing is that my dad came out the same way. My dad was a very successful human being, and you know, and is well off financially, drives the ugliest car in the world. And I always tell him, Dad, why do you drive this disgusting car? Get yourself a new car. And he always says, if I spent money on everything that I ever wanted, then I wouldn't have money for when I really need it. Which is exactly what his father used to tell him. Where does that conversation come from? It's not even my viewpoint. It's not me. I didn't invent that. I never made that up. It's from my father, but my father didn't make it up either. It's my grandfather's. It's totally inherited. And not only is it inherited, I have been living my life financially like a Holocaust survivor that the Nazis took everything away from him. When I don't buy myself $150 ear pods, it's because that's what my grandfather would say. When I discovered this, I literally broke out in tears that I don't allow myself things that I want, even though I can, because the Nazis took everything away from my grandfather. I was completely blind to it, but I was very clear that that's the truth, that that's how it is. Anybody who buys ear pods is a freaking idiot.